first come into your app project, you're going to see the home canvas by default. The home canvas is unique in the Mobilesmith platform in comparison to the other canvases. Other canvases, you have the ability to scroll up and down, but the home screen itself is designed to fill the entire screen of the device it's being displayed on. This provides the ability to use larger high-resolution images without having to worry about loading time when a user opens the app, which is advantageous of a native app versus a web application. User interface is important in Mobilesmith, and we want it to be important for your end users. So we've built the home screen with design logic so that all devices end up with a professional looking home page. You'll notice on the home canvas here, there is a gray divider line down here at the bottom. This divider line was put in place so that larger devices would be able to fit better on the screens. Initially, when the platform was created, it was created in mind with an iPhone 4. So iPhone 4 and smaller Android devices use this top area of the screen, while larger devices use this extension down at the bottom. If you put anything in this extension area, do be advised that if you do have any iPhone 4 users, they're not going to be able to see what's down here. So one of the more important parts that also make the home canvas unique is how you're able to split it up. With other canvases, you can drag and drop items onto the screen and you'll be able to stretch them out. However, on the home canvas, you're going to need to create something called split lines. Split lines are going to divide the canvas up into areas where you can drag and drop either a text label, an image label, or buttons onto the screen in accordance to how you want to design your app. To create a split line, you are going to right-click, and you will get a menu here that gives you the option to split the area vertically or horizontally. When you choose that, you're going to get a divider line, and the divider line you can move up and down as you see fit. If you right-click in the area, whether it's above or below, and choose to split that region again, it's going to split the region equally into two parts. And again, you can create another split line. If you don't want that specific dimension, you can move the line over and then create another split line to divide the area how you see fit. You can make as many split lines as you want, and again, each time you make one, it's going to split that area in half equally. And you can also come down into the extension and split that area as well if you want. Or if you find that you don't need the split line, you can just put your mouse right on top of it, right click, and hit remove. Just be advised that if you come in and you remove these lines out of any specific order, what will happen is that when you remove it, it will remove all the lines that were made prior to it. That is because the home canvas calculates the space, and if you remove a line out of the order that you created it in, it's going to remove everything else because it doesn't know how you want to use that space. Another thing that you're going to notice on all the canvases, and not just the home canvas, is that you will see this bar up here at the top. Each one of these lines marks 40 pixels on the canvas. So if I come in here and I create a split line, I'll be able to determine how many pixels apart they are. But if you want to know exactly how many pixels are in that area, you can right-click and look down here at the bottom to get your pixel height and width. This is very important, especially when you're creating buttons for your home canvas, and those images have to be PNG files so that they're going to be able to be seen clearly. So the home canvas, like I said, is here by default. Every app project that you have is going to have one. Do you necessarily have to use the home canvas as your landing page? You do not, and I'll show you how to do that in another lesson later on.